clothing. And it's at this point when they're comfortable that we're gonna do a nice, beautiful hand wash. Part two, apparently I restarted the video. So we have just prepared our client and now we're gonna wash our hands. So we are going to wet our hands underneath the sink. We're gonna wash our hands down to our wrist. We're gonna wash the back of our hands down to our wrist. We are going to wash our fingers and we're gonna wash the back of our fingers. We wet our hands, we found liquid hand soap, if I did not say that already, which I don't think I did. We're gonna wash between our fingers. We're gonna wash between our fingers and our thumb. We're gonna wash our fingertips. We are going to wash our wrists and our thumbs. And we're gonna do all of that proper hand wash for 20 to 30 seconds. And we're gonna thoroughly rinse it off underneath the sink, and then either get a clean towel, disposable paper towels, turn the water off, thoroughly dry those hands down, and then trash your paper towels, and then you can grab your hand sanitizer and sanitize away. You wanna make sure at this point that the hands are super dry, and the reason for that is you've gotta put your disposable gloves on for this service. So you want to make sure they're not wet or it will be challenging to get your gloves on. And my gloves are on. So the first thing you wanna do for your client is remove any makeup that they might have on their eyes. So that's what we're gonna do first. We're gonna get our cotton rounds with our makeup remover and we are going to take off her makeup. Very important that we get that off for this. So take your time here. If you find that you need to do a couple passes or a couple times, you can. Everyone's different. I just take my time, make sure I get that makeup off. And then one thing that we want to add is that we want to dry everything really nicely. Love it, love it. Because we're going to use lash adhesive, so we want to make sure that her eye area is nice and dry. And then you're gonna grab your disposable mascara wand and you're gonna comb through those lashes. And the reason for that is you want to get the artificial lash strip as close to the lash line as you can. So it just keeps them nicely together. No stray lashes going crazy. You can just really see where they are. So it'll be easier for you to apply your lash strip. And then you discard that. So before you apply the lashes, a couple things to know. There is a right side and a left side to that set. And what you have to do is look for the short side of the lash and then it goes out to the long side. So the shortest side is always gonna be placed in towards the nose. The longest side will be side of that lash will be out to the side of the face. So you'll be able to decide when you pick up and you can see which side is short and which side is long, which eye it will go to. So the first thing you wanna do is measure. You won't need any glue. You're just simply gonna use your hands. You're gonna take that strip lash, finding that short side, finding that long side, and you're just gonna line it up with the length of the eye along the lash line, just to see if you need to do any special trimming. A lot of times they're really, really long and everybody's eyes are different sizes. So I have measured, believe it or not, this lash strip is really close to my mannequin's eye size, but I'm gonna show you how to trim. So what you do is you hold the edge of the long side that might be too long with the extra length, and then you're gonna grab a pair of scissors and you're gonna do a nice little trim, and you're gonna make sure that you trim on the top of the lashes, like on the top of your fingers rather than below, because you would make it too short. You just wanna cut off the teensy bit that you need to. Once you've sized it, you're gonna flip it over on the back side, and then you're gonna put on your lash glue. So that's what we're gonna do now. We're gonna get our disposable applicator for the glue and our lash adhesive, and we're gonna take a little bit of glue and just apply it along the length of the lash from corner to corner. You don't need a lot, but you do wanna do that even spread. And then you're gonna toss your applicator into the trash. Locate your tweezers, because you're going to hold the tweezers. The tweezers are gonna hold the lash, and you're gonna hold the tweezers as you apply that lash strip. So I'm about halfway between side to side on my lash strip, and then I'm gonna go take it down to her lash line. When I apply it to her lash line, I'm gonna press that inner corner in first, and then I'm gonna work my way out as I press down. And you may find that you need a good 4 to 5 second window there, maybe longer if you need to make any adjustments while the glue has not set. This is the time to do it. And then I just try to wait a minute, not technically a minute, but 10, 15 seconds, four to five seconds, whatever you feel like is good before you start the process all over again. So you can do exactly the same process on the other lash for the other eye. So we have to measure first. So I'm grabbing that lash. I found my short side and my long side. I'm taking my short side to the inside of the nose, and I have no glue or anything on it. I'm simply just lining it up with the length of the eye and measuring corner to corner. And really it's great, but for the sake of the video, I'm gonna pretend to trim a little bit. So what I've got is the long side, a little bit between my fingers, grabbing my scissors, and once again, cutting off the top above my fingers, which is the longest side. And then my strip has been sized appropriately, so I can turn it over, and now I can apply some of that lash adhesive to the strip lash. So I'm gonna take a little bit of the lash adhesive and apply it along the lash. And I'm throwing away that single-use applicator, finding my tweezers so that my tweezers can hold the lashes as we go in to then lay it along the lash line. Once again, I'm going to press it down, and I'm gonna press first to that inner corner, working my way out to the outer corner of the eye. And sometimes you need to do the hold while it sets up, while the glue sets up. And then waiting, making sure everything is on. Her lashes look amazing. Hi. She's gonna be super happy. And then when you feel like she can open her eyes and everything looks really, really good, you grab that mirror and show your client, because you know she's gonna be like so happy to see herself. Oh my gosh, she's in love with them. And then you are getting ready to check her out. So you're gonna take those gloves off, and they're disposable, so you can toss them, of course. And you'll remove the drape, the headband, anything else that you, any linens or anything that she might have had, blanket or et cetera, and you'll go get her checked out. So she is ready to go. And basically at this point, what you wanna do with your client follow-up here is discuss maintenance and aftercare, which for these, they're really single-use items. You could tell her, obviously, when she washes her face, you're gonna tell her how to take them off. And tell her if she does want to reuse them, she might get one or two more uses out of them. They're not designed to be worn every day over and over. She's gone, she's checked out, and you need to get back to your room because you got to get ready for your next client. So let's talk about what happens when that transpires. So you go to your room and you're gonna throw away any single use items. You will place your implements in a closed container that's labeled to be disinfected. You are going to get any of that soiled laundry, headband, towel, drape, you're gonna put that in a closed container until it's time for that laundry. And then you're gonna identify a proper cleaning agent and read the manufacturer's directions. Follow the manufacturer's directions for mixing and usage. Wipe the workstation or area with cleaning solution to remove debris. Then you will identify a disinfectant that is bactericidal, virucidal, and fungicidal, EPA approved for use in a salon setting, which means you've got to put some gloves on. You're gonna follow manufacturer's directions for mixing and or using appropriate aerosol disinfectant. You will disinfect electrical equipment, store it in a clean area separate from other implements, remove those gloves, you can toss them, and then you have to wash your hands. So find that sink, wet your hands, find that liquid hand soap, wash your hands down to your wrists. You're gonna wash the back of your hands down to your wrists. You are gonna wash your fingers. You're gonna wash the backs of your fingers. You are gonna wash your fingertips and nails, between the fingers and the thumb. You're gonna wash the thumbs. You're gonna wash the wrists. You're gonna do all of that mega wash, 20 to 30 second minimum, and then you're gonna thoroughly rinse it under the water. Find a clean towel or disposable paper towels, grab it, turn the water off with the towel hand, completely dry your hands off, throw the paper towels in the trash, and then find that hand sanitizer, 70% ethyl alcohol, and rub your hands together, making sure you get everything sanitized as well, nice and dry. And then you are ready to go and perform your next service. So you're gonna get everything set up for that. So that concludes your video on artificial lash application.